Because I care, the most I care, Mashiach Abishai care, but you don't care enough. Matthew 16 and 24. Yeah, we definitely need to fast and pray. Matthew 16, 24. Then said Mashiach Abishai unto his disciples, if any man will come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross and follow me. You got to deny yourself. That's why I told us in Romans 12 and 1. Look, I went right to it. Romans 12 and 1. I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of the Most High. Hear that? Mercies. Getting something you don't deserve. We get something we don't even deserve. Mercies over and over and over again. I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of the Most High, that ye present your bodies a living sacrifice. Holy. Keeping the laws of the Most High. Having faith in the Mashiach Abishai. Acceptable unto the Most High, which is your reasonable service. That's the least you can do, he's saying. Let your body be a living sacrifice. That's what he's saying here in Matthew 16 and 24. Then said Mashiach Abishai unto his disciples, if any man will come after me, let him deny himself. Deny yourself. Let your body be a living sacrifice. Deny yourself and take up his cross and follow me. What do you think that's talking about? That ain't no good life. That ain't nothing going to be all sweet like honey. You think the cross was? The cross was death. He died. They said on the cross. That was death. Be ready to live for Mashiach Yahushua. To the glory of the Most High. That's what he's saying. For whosoever will save his life shall lose it. And whosoever will lose his life for my sake shall find it. Hear that? For his sake. But remember, he said he was in the world. The world was made by him, and the world knew him not. That world is in Isaiah 45, 17. Israel is that world without end. Because he was just in the midst of us. He wasn't amongst every people. All the people came around like they do whenever we go out to meet our people. These other nations come around and bring discords to the word of the Most High. Because they're not dealing with this truth. It's not for them. They can listen and learn. Everybody you're going to learn one way or another. Or you're going to be put to death. Simple as that. You don't want Mashiach Abishai to rule over you? He said, bring hither and slay them before me. Luke 19, 27, all day, all night, 24-7. Simple as that. He's coming to rule everyone with a rod of iron. That rod of iron is just laws. Oh, yeah. Listen. Verse 26, for what is a man profited if he shall gain the whole world and lose his own soul? So what you going to profit it? Look at all these rich men and rich women and wealthy in this world. You gain the whole world and they're going to lose their soul, man. So what profit it? If he shall gain the whole world and lose his own soul. But what shall a man give in exchange for his soul? See? What will a man give for in exchange for his soul? I mean, they have you doing all kind of madness up there in Hollywood and so forth. Men now, they got put on dresses, our men, all the time. You see it over and over again. What will a man give for his own soul? Or what shall a man give in exchange for his soul? That's why you got the devil offering you all kinds of things. That's why you got to recognize the left-hand side I mean, they offer you whatever they want with a smile. Laughing. And before they love, they love. I mean, the only one that accepts everybody is Satan. He said, hey, he accepts everybody. Make it fun for you to be thrown in the lake of fire later. How you have fun now, like I say. Laugh now with them and cry later. Verse 27. For the Son of Man shall come in the glory of his Father. He coming, y'all. He coming in the glory of the Most High. With his angels. And then he shall reward every man according to his works. Then he will reward every man according to his works, what you have done in these mortal bodies. We got to be ready. It's getting closer and closer. You don't know what's going to be the deal. You don't know when things are going to pop off. And next thing you know, it's about the judgment. Mark 8:38. Whosoever therefore shall be ashamed of me and of my words in this adulterous and sinful generation, of him also shall the Son of Man be ashamed when he cometh in the glory of his Father with the holy angels. 200 million, it says in Revelation 9:16. Let's read it. He'll be ashamed of you. You're ashamed of him. He's going to be ashamed of you when he comes with his holy angels. And the number of the army of the horsemen were 200,000. And I heard the number of them. 200 million angels that he's coming back with. Oh, yeah. That's what we have to have ourselves right. Look at Luke 9:27. See, but I tell you of a truth, there be some standing here which shall not taste of death till they see the kingdom of the Most High. Hear that? Some that were standing before Mashiach was shy when he lived in the flesh. They never taste of death till they see the kingdom of the Most High. I mean, they're going to come back. They're going to be right here in 1 Thessalonians 4:16. For Mashiach Yahushua himself shall descend from heaven. Just like he ascended up in heaven, he's going to descend from heaven. From the fourth dimension, with a shout, and with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of the Most High, and the dead, by Shema Mashiach Yahushua, shall rise first. That's them that never seen death. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up with together with them in the clouds, which are the chariots of the Most High, when you read Psalms 104:3. To meet Hamashiach Yahushua in the air. With the glory of the Most High. They're coming. And so shall we ever be with Hamashiach Yahushua and the Most High. The Most High and Hamashiach Yahushua. Wherefore comfort one another with these words. See? That's beautiful. Now, it also reminds us again in Revelation 11:12. And they heard a great voice from heaven saying unto them, come up hither. Said, come on up. Remember, keep coming with 200 men angels. We see that. And they heard a great voice from heaven saying unto them, come up hither. And they ascended up to heaven in the cloud, which is a chariot. You read Psalms 104:3. And the enemies beheld them. So enemies are going to be looking up. They're going to be looking up at Israel going up in these chariots. These chariots come down to get us and take us back up in the air. And our enemies said, our enemies beheld them. Held us. And what they're going to be saying. Let's look at something that they're going to be saying in Wisdom of Solomon, the 5th chapter. So they're going to be amazed at the strangeness of his salvation. See, like they say, our enemies are going to behold us. And Wisdom of Solomon 5:2, you know, when they see it, they shall be filled with terrible fear. And shall be amazed at the strangeness of his salvation, so far beyond all that they look for. You see? Remember, our enemies gonna see us going up. These chariots coming, 200 million of them, coming out, redeeming us from all over four corners of the earth. What they're gonna be saying today, repenting and groaning for anguish of spirit, shall say within themselves, this was he whom we had sometimes in derision, in a proverb of reproach, a disgraceful way of thinking, been lied to everyone. Oh yeah, we know. Because it tells you what would happen. In Revelations 12:15, and the serpent, which is red, the devil and Satan and the beast and the Esau and all of them, red. And the serpent cast out of his mouth water as a flood. These are lies. After the woman who was the children of Israel. Jeremiah 6:2 says, I have likened the daughter of Zion. Zion represents the 12 tribes of Israel. In Isaiah 51:16. So, the serpent cast out of his mouth water as a flood. These are lies. After the woman, after Israel, lying to us that he might cause her to be carried away of the flood. Cause us to be carried away with the lies. And a lot of our people, they're carried away with the lies. They believe his story. They believe what they see on the news. Trump even called it fake news. You know what I mean? Come on. They tell it on each other now. And here we are still believing the lies. But we that are of the called, this applies to us. Verse 16, and the earth helped the woman. The earth helped us. We the Israelites. And the earth opened her mouth. The earth opened her mouth to bring forth the archaeology, the true history, anthropology, and all the things that we needed to be able to come back to the knowledge, wisdom, understanding of the understanding, first and foremost, of this Bible. Precept upon precept, precept upon precept, line upon line, line upon line, here a little and there a little. See, they think they had us in derision, in a reproach, a disgrace. Look at our people, man, they're disgraceful. No different than you look at, what's that movie, Goodbye Uncle Tom? We had the women, the little girls, every boys, everybody in there naked, having sex with them, getting them prepared for just disgraceful. No different than these videos. You see the women out there butt naked, just dancing in the videos and so forth. Little or nothing. You might as well be butt naked. You just got a G-string on. You ain't got no clothes on. Just disgraceful. But see, Mashiach Yahusha was given us by the Most High. And we shame, brought him to an open shame. So he said, I'm going to make your glory, which is the woman, for us, shameful. And we see it. If you don't see that, then I don't know what you're looking at. But see, the earth helped the woman, helped the Israelites. And the earth opened her mouth to bring forth this knowledge and some understanding in all that aspect of understanding. And swallowed up the flood, swallowed up the lies. That's why we can call it what we call it. The devil was deceitful, evil person. Deceit means what? You lie. And you evil. And you were made, as it says in Proverbs 16:4, for the evil day. Purposely, the wicked is made for the evil day. Most of them make everything for himself. Yeah, even the wicked for the day of evil. And that's what time we in now. See? So we swallowing up them floods. So the dragon was wroth with the woman. It'll be wroth with the children of Israel. And went to make war with the remnant of her seed. The remnant of her seed. What's the one third? That's a remnant. The one third. Brothers and sisters, you got to understand. They're going to make war with the one third that's going to be redeemed. Because we got next. We got next forever and ever and ever. We got next. Forever and ever and ever. Which keep the commandments of the Most High and have the testimony of Amashiach Yahushai. That ain't the churches. They already got them. Because they don't believe. They don't believe in keeping the commandments of the Most High. What church you go to that's Baptist or Saint or Lutheran or Jehovah's Witness or that keep the feast days? Keep the new moon feast, which is a law. First day of the month. Keep the holy convocations. Defy Caesar Borgia, that white image of dear Jesus Christ that was painted in 1492. Where he at? So we as a remnant, going back to the Apocrypha, letting you know that's for us. This is what they're going to do when salvation comes to Israel. This is Psalm 5:3. And they repented and groaning for anguish of spirit. See, they're going to be mad. They're going to be angry of spirit. Because they're going to be amazed at the strangeness of our salvation. Because they don't know. And they're never going to know. Because it's not in them to know. Just like you can't mix oil with water, even though they do. Take all the oil out of the earth and put water there. You can't mix righteousness with wickedness and evil either. Anguish of spirit shall say within themselves, this was he, not him, whom we had sometime in derision and a proverb of reproach. We fools accounted his life madness and his end to be without honor. So we fools accounted his life madness and his end to be without honor. How is he numbered among the children of the Most High, and seeing us going up in these chariots? What they're going to be saying, people? How's he numbered among the children of the Most High? And his lot is among the saints? Among the saints. We are the saints. Therefore have we erred from the way of truth. So any of you following them, you fit into the category of Aaron from the way of truth also. This is what they're saying. When salvation is coming to the 12 tribes of Israel, it's all here. The past, the present, and the future. It's the future. And the light of righteousness, which is the laws of the Most High, Proverbs 6:23, have not shined unto us. Because it ain't for them. and the Son of righteousness rose not upon us. See? We reared ourselves in the way of wickedness and destruction. Everywhere they go, it's wickedness and they destroy. They're just like hell, it says. Yeah, we have gone through deserts where there lay no way. But as for the way of the Most High and the Mashiach Yahushua, we have not known it. See? They have not known it, people. So how you going to follow someone that is telling you that's the future right there? They say they ain't known it. But how many people going to follow them and go right to hell with them? We'll tell you in Isaiah 13:15, all them joining to them going to fall by the sword. You make the call. Because what else can you do? Because you're going to be a sinner because they're teaching you not under the law. You ain't got to follow the Most High. When everybody say you're not under the law, they say you ain't got to follow the Most High. But they'll tell you follow them. Look, this the Most High. The power that I serve. I don't know who you serve. This is the power that I serve. This is what he said in Job 12:24. He taketh away the heart of the chief of the people of the earth. He taketh away the mind of the chief people of the earth. Who the superpower of the earth? The Edomites. I mean, 2 Ezra 6:9 says, and Esau is the end of the world. Jacob is the beginning of it that followed. You know, Esau is going to be ruling when at the end of the earth, end of the world. That we announce, we'll say he taketh away the heart of the chief of the people of the earth and causes them to wander in the wilderness where there lay no way. My check on shot last, I read in St. John 14:6, he said, I am the way. Remember, it says, after the way of the Most High, we have not known it. That's when we reach the salvation. They know they're not going to ever know. Reach the salvation, that's what they're going to be saying. You see? They grope in dark. They grope in the dark without light. That's why he told them in Isaiah 47:5, get thee into darkness and not light. Ignorance. So I say, how is it that they're telling you through the Spirit of the Most High they will not know him? They grope in the dark without light, and he maketh them to stagger like a drunken man. You don't know where they're going, like a drunken man. Drunken man, that's why they call it liquor spirits. That's why he said the influence that they have. Can't even stand up straight, can't even walk straight. But they say he make them stagger like a drunken man. Go to Daniel 10:10. And behold, an hand touched me, which set me upon my knees and upon the palms of my hand. And he said unto me, O Daniel, a man greatly beloved, understand the words that I speak unto thee, and stand upright. For unto thee am I now sent. And when he had spoken this word unto me, I stood trembling. So how about this angel? He stood trembling. This said he unto me, fear not, Daniel, for from the first day that thou didst set thine heart or your mind to understand and to chasten thyself before thy power, thy words were heard, and I am come for thy words. See that? Humility, crying to the Most High. But the prince of the kingdom of Persia without withstood me 21 days. But lo, Michael, one of the chief princes, came to help me. You know what that is? Michael the archangel. And I remained there with the kings of Persia. Now am I come to make thee understand what shall befall thy people in the latter days. For yet the vision is for many days, and we in the last days. And when he had spoken such words unto me, I set my face toward the ground, and I became dumb. See, he put his face on the ground, became dumb. That's why I say, people, are you ready? And behold, one like the similitude of the sons of men touched my lips. Then I opened my mouth and spake and said unto him that stood before me, O my power, by the vision my sorrows are turned unto me, and I have retained no strength. He's sad and the strength is just leaving him. For how can the servant of this my power talk with this my power? For as for me, straightway there remained no strength in me, neither is there breath left in me. But not only the strength, he almost can't breathe. And it came again and touched me at once like the appearance of a man. And he strengthened me. See? That's why it tells you in Hebrews 13:2. Strength of a man. People don't know. Be not forgetful to entertain strangers. But thereby, some have entertained angels unaware. Thinking that everybody that you see is just a normal person as you are. Daniel 10:18. Then there came again and touched me, one like the appearance of a man, and he strengthened me. You see, just like when you look at a Mashiach El Shai. Go to Luke, the 4th chapter. After you had dealt with a Mashiach El Shai. Go to Salakia, go to Matthew, the 4th chapter. These are both the stories. I want to get right to the point of the same story. Matthew 4 and look at verse 11. Matthew 4:11. Then the devil leaveth him just after he fasted for 40 days. And behold, angels came and ministered unto him. See? Comforted him. So these are the things we got to look at. Look at Daniel 12:9. And he said, go thy way, Daniel, for the words are closed up and sealed to the time of the end. Many shall be purified and made white and tried, but the wicked shall do wickedly. See, the wicked gonna do wickedly. And none of the wicked shall understand, but the wise shall understand. You hear that? That's why it says, as for the way of the Most High, as the way of a Mashiach El Shai, they have not known it. But see, we have angels that comfort us. Remember, Mashiach El Shai made things visible and invisible. And we have the holy angels. If you go to the Most High with humility and a broken contrite spirit, that will protect us. Because they're here on the earth. The vengeance of the Most High. Angels that's ready for the vengeance of the Most High. And they will protect us. That's why Satan told the Most High, hey, when he said, have you considered my servant Job? In Job, the first chapter, 6th verse down, he said, hey, you protecting them. You know, but take your right hand from them and release your left hand on them, and I'll have them curse you to your face. You see? Take them righteous angels around from around them, and I'll make them curse you to your face. So he took that hedge from over Job. And Satan was able to go down and do what he did, as you read about it, through the power of the Most High. Listen, Daniel 12 and 10. Many shall be purified and made white, meaning made pure, righteous, and tried. You hear that? It ain't going to be no easy task. And tried, dipped in the fiery furnace of affliction, or through a lot of things. But the wicked shall do wickedly. Hear that? The wicked going to do wickedly. That's why they don't know the Most High. That's why they don't know what Mashiach is, because they're doing wickedly. They ain't trying to follow. That's contrary to following the law, statutes, commandments of the Most High. And none of the wicked shall understand. So when you see our people don't understand, they wicked. None of the wicked shall understand this truth. But the wise shall understand. The wise going to understand. See? That's why it's very important that we come back to the Most High and follow Him and be obedient. That's what's important. But how are you going to be obedient if you don't know how to be obedient? You ain't been taught how to be obedient. You just follow your own little instincts of what you learning on the internet or whatever you learning on your own. Titus, go to Titus, the 3rd chapter in the 8th verse. Titus, 3rd chapter, in the 8th verse. This is a faithful saying, and these things I will, that thou will affirm constantly, that they which have believed in the Most High, while Mashiach Yahushua, might be careful to maintain good works. You got to be careful to maintain good works. These things are good and profitable unto men. See? You got to make sure that you're maintaining good works. That means you got to be consistent. You can't be like some of you applaud you. Especially when you look at, you come on, especially if you're on a conference call, you coming on at 10 o'clock at night, 3 hour difference, or 9 o'clock at night, 2 hour difference from Cali's time. And you on till 1 o'clock in the morning. Some of you have to get up and go to work. That has to be applauded. Well, you have people that could be in class. They're not in class. They just doing their thing. You have those that could be there. That I'll just wait till the video comes. They don't even speak to me. They don't say nothing to me at all. But they're learning from me. But then the Most High understand is the angels are putting in the books. You see? And there's no reason for that. We the body of a Mashiach Yahushua. We supposed to be, Most High love Jacob, so we supposed to be loving each other, caring about each other. That's why I say, but avoid foolish questions and genealogies and contentions and strivings about the law, for they are unprofitable and vain. See? A lot of foolish questions you don't even need to be dealing with. People are not spiritual. It's hard to bring about spiritual understanding to those that are not spiritual, but carnal. They just, you know, require a sign for everything, or just try and come up with their own explanation of what this is and what this means, and then try and be justified in how they feel, or not to be made right in the way they think. So, and the only way you're going to be made right is to be taught what's right. You can't assume. You know what assumption does. You know what assuming. But it's not to me, because I'm going to be able to tell you what's right. If I can, if not, then I'll just accept my mom. I don't know. I ain't got no problem saying I don't know. Because I know in part and prophesying, probably like anybody else. Matthew, the 5th chapter and the 16th verse. It says, let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. Give all glory to the Most High. What he's saying, no matter what works you do, you got to give all praise and glory to the Most High. But why the Most High? All praise to the Most High for everything. But your works that you're doing can be before men. They can see what you're doing. You ain't got to tell about what you're doing. They'll see what you're doing, especially now with the social media and all that. They can see what you're doing. If there's a lot, if it's a little, whatever it is, people looking at what you're doing. You know, I go to the Masharaya Sharala summits and I'll be uplifted because you see brothers there that you haven't seen in a while, or you see them every so many months and they're growing. You see the growth in our brothers, you know, the minds and spirits and soul and the love that's is tremendous in a high level, more so than ever. And you're able to expound on them things that you have learned spiritually between each other. And we're growing in the spirit together, you know? And then men, you know, they commend the work that you do. You got to tell everybody what you're doing. Everybody can see what you're doing. If you speak, they know about who you are too. Are you that silent? The angels know. And the Most High revealed the secrets to his servants and prophets. So it's going to come back around. We ain't getting away with nothing. That's why it says, let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works. They can see what you're doing. They can see your good works. I know bad works. You know, everybody look for something to get, find fault in each other. But let people see your good works. You ain't got to boast about this, that, the third, nothing, because it don't matter. It don't matter in the eyes of the Most High. He had no respect to persons. No respect to persons. He only had respect to Israel. He had respect to us coming together, assembling ourselves together as the Israelites. That's what, and who we have respect to when we come together. Because we can't be together. If we're not together, ain't no respect to, Most have no respect to persons. Y'all individualists, you out there, he don't have respect for you. He have respect for those that's working in assembly of our people. Us coming together, even if it's on a conference call, it's still, we still coming together. We're assembling ourselves. And we studying this word. So I say, let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. They see your good works. They get commend you with your works. You say, all praise to the Most High. That's how it's got to be done. Give him the praise. Ezekiel 33. The book of Ezekiel, the 33rd chapter. Ezekiel, the 33rd chapter, and verse 30. Also, thou son of man, the children of thy people still are talking against thee by the walls and in the doors of the houses, and speak one to another, every one to his brother, saying, come, I pray you, and hear what is the word that cometh forth from the Most High. And they come unto thee as the people cometh, and they sit before thee as my people, and they hear thy words, but they will not do them. So, I mean, this is nothing new under the sun, right? They hear the words, but they will not do them. For with their mouth they show much love, but their heart, their mind, go up after their covetousness, the things they desire. And that's something that somebody else have generally. And lo, thou art unto them as a very lovely song of one that hath a pleasant voice and can play well on an instrument, like hearing beautiful music being played on an instrument. For they hear thy words, but they do them not. Man, that's deep. How the Spirit is speaking expressively. And when it's coming to pass, lo, it will come. It's coming. I see it. Then shall they know that a prophet has been among them. Wow. Hear the words, but they do them not. Galatians 3 and 11. That's why I keep saying you got to change. You got to become a new creature. Be born again. Galatians 3. And 11. But that no man is justified by the law in the sight of the Most High, it is evident. For the just shall live by faith. And the law is not of faith, but the man that doeth them shall live in them. Mashiach of Shai has redeemed us from the curse of the law, being made a curse for us. Talking about the law of sacrifice. That's the sacrifice that he made for the children of Israel. We just read it in Acts 5 and 31. Mashiach of Shai, verse 13, has redeemed us from the curse of the law, being made a curse for us, for it is written, cursed is everyone that hangeth on a tree. See? So, we have to have faith. We got to have faith. In the Mashiach of Shai, going to the Most High on our behalf, to fan the flames away from us. Most High is a consuming fire. Nobody sacrifices no animals no more for no atonement of sins. Habakkuk, the second chapter. Habakkuk 2. And let's look at that verse 4. Behold, his soul which is lifted up is not upright in him, but the just shall live by his faith. You see. But his soul which is lifted up in is not upright in him. That's because he prideful. This man that's ruling out, very, very prideful. And how does the Most High feel about that? Go to Ecclesiasticus 10. That's for any man, woman, or child. Go Go to Ecclesiasticus, the 10th chapter, and verse 7. Pride is hateful before the Most High and man, and by both does one commit iniquity, wickedness. By both, so they commit iniquity or wickedness of breaking the Most High's laws, statutes, and commandments. It's real, people. Look at Isaiah 2, Isaiah the 2nd chapter. See, we got to cover both spectrum of it, right and wrong, to get understanding. Go to Isaiah, the 2nd chapter, 11th verse, and verse 12. For all those, like I say, lifted up in pride. The lofty looks of man shall be humbled, and the haughtiness of men shall be bowed down. Hear that? The lofty, all these prideful looks that they have shall be humbled. Gonna be humbled. And the haughtiness of men shall be bowed down, and the Most High, what must I go shy, alone shall be exalted in that day. For the day of the Most High, and the Mashiach Yahushua of hosts of armies, shall be upon every one that is proud and lofty, and upon every one that is lifted up, and he shall be brought low. See? Gonna bring him down. That's what he's telling us. It don't work, people. Look at go to 1 Timothy the 6th chapter. 1 Timothy the 6th chapter. Oh yeah, the Most High ain't playing. You can play around if you want to, but it's coming to a head, y'all. 1 Timothy 6 and verse 10. 1 Timothy 6 and 10. For the love of money is the root of all evil. Not money, but the love of money is the root of all evil, which while some coveted after, they have erred from the faith. See? That's what this is about. Faith. Fruits of faith by your works. For the love of money is the root of all evil, which while some coveted after, they have erred from the faith and pierce themselves through with many sorrows. Because they're always concerned about money, 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 money. Now, all you that have a lot of money, you wealthy, it's just to you. Verse 17, 1 Timothy 6, 17. Charge them that are rich in this world, that they be not high-minded. What's that high-minded? Be prideful. Just told you that's hateful before Most High-end man. And by it does one commit iniquity, wickedness, breaking the laws of the Most High. Charge them that are rich in this world, and that they be not high-minded, not be prideful, nor trust in uncertain riches, but in the living power who give us richly all things to enjoy. See? Trust in the Most High power of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, Jacob being the forefather of the 12 tribes of Israel, that they do good, that they be rich in good works. That's what we're talking about all night. Be rich in good works. Do the things that's going to please the Most High. Ready to distribute. Distribute what? Distribute their money to help this truth continue to go forward. Willing to communicate. Willing to communicate with us. As others did prior to us living in this lifetime of today. Listen, you do this. It say, laying up in store for themselves a good foundation against the time to come. Because see, if you don't have that, a lot of you will be put to death right with the enemy or the Most High and the enemy of HaMashiach Yahushua. Say, laying up in store for themselves a good foundation against the time to come, that they may lay hold on eternal life. Hear that? That's what this is all about. So, if you think it's not worth it, then, hey, maybe this is your salvation now. This all that you can look forward to. Let's go to James, the second chapter. Very good book concerning our topic. James 2, and let's look at 14. What does it profit, my brethren, you Hebrew Israelites? Do a man say he have faith and have not works? Can faith save him? You have faith, but you don't follow the laws of the Most High. You think all you gotta do is call on the name of Jesus, you're gonna be saved and all that they teach you in the church. This is what he said. What does it profit, my brethren? Do a man say he have faith and have not works, keeping the laws of the Most High? Can faith save him? Can faith save you? You have works. You don't have works. Can faith save you? You have works and faith. Yeah, you're working them together. Like we read in Revelations 14th chapter and the 22nd chapter, last chapter of the Bible, verse 14 and so forth. What does it profit, my brethren, though a man say he have faith and have not works? Can faith save him? If a brother or sister be naked, destitute of daily food, and one of you say unto them, depart in peace, be ye warmed and filled. Notwithstanding, ye give them not those things which are needful to the body, what does it profit? I mean, they hungry, they need something to eat, you don't give them nothing to eat. What difference do it make? What does that profit? Even so, faith, if it has not works, is dead being alone. See? They have taught you lies. Yeah, a man may say, thou hast faith, and I have works. Show me thy faith without thy works, and I will show thee my faith by my works. Now, I really believe, like what we started with. You know, have faith in the Most High. Did thou believe it, that there is one power? Thou do it well. The devils also believe and tremble. Hear that? But where we at? When we talk about